Hello students, welcome back to the online class. Today I will discuss a new topic. It is how to print a web page. Okay, so print a web page means what? When you visit the website, for example, say www.wikipedia.com. Okay, so Wikipedia is a website, where you search any informations. Okay, so when you see the when you search any information, say like I will search a bird information, B-I-R-D bird. After that, you search on this topic, and you will get lot of informations about bird. Okay, so if you want to print this current web page, this is a current web page. Current web page means what? Which you are now viewing. Okay, this is the current web page. Then you can print this web page with the help of printers or any other devices. Okay, so actually here you can see in your book, you can see here how to print a web page. You can see here, to print a web page that you viewing, click the tools button and then select print. Okay, in a, there is a tool button in a web browser, Internet Explorer, and after that you just just select the tool button, and after that there is a print options, and after that you can just click the print options. It will automatically print the content of this web page. Content means what? Content of the web page means what? Content means what? It may be sometimes images, text, graphics, animations, okay, dates, everything. Say PDF file, okay, anything, whatever the content is available or whatever the content is included in this web page, all the contents will be printed. Okay, so in this way you can easily print a web page from any websites. In your exams it may be counted how to print a web page. You just write the steps which is given in the books. Okay, now next one is how to save a web page. Save a web page is so important, because now see, save a web page, save a web page means what? If you want to visit any websites, for example, I want to visit google.com. after that you just type any information, say like any topic. Okay, so after that you want to save the particular web page. Okay, say example, say okay, in google.com, you will go to google.com, and after that there is a text box and there is a search option here. Okay, you write text, write any text, say like programming language. Okay, write programming language. After that you search, click the search button. After that there are many websites. Okay, many websites available. After that you just click a particular website. For example, say any websites. Programming website, say like tutorial.com. tutorial.com. Is a tutorial.com is a programming web page where you will get the programming language, any programming language, say like C++, Java, C Sharp, PHP, anything. And in the website you want to search any programming language, say plus C++ programming language. In programming language, there is in the programming language here. In the C++ programming, if you want to save the information, is actually working web page or the current web page. Current web page means there is a program is here, C++ program is here, and you like this program. Okay, if you want to like this web page or website's content, if you want to like the website content, means you want to save the informations of this website particularly. That's why you want to save the web page. For saving the web page, there is our steps are given here. You can see in the page number 236, how to save
with peace, there is a lot of here, you will get lot of tips here.
Just remind, remember the tips, but I'm just discuss the web page, how, why we save the web page, because if you like the website content or web page content, then you can easily save the web page. You can easily save the web page. Save the web page means what? You save the all the contents, details of these websites, images, tags, graphics, animations, everything. Okay. And there is another advantage of saving a web page in your desktop, in your PC. For example, if you are offline, sometimes if you are not connected to the internet, if you are offline, at a time you want to again visit these websites, you again want this code, particular code, C++ programming code. At a time, if you have no internet, then how to connect this website? How to connect to these websites? So at a time, you can view this web page with the help of the existing web page, which is already saved. Means this website is already saved in your desktop or in your PCs. Okay, so at a time no need to go internet, no need to go online. This website contain all the contents are available offline because it is already saved into your computer. Okay, that's why there is a big advantage of saving a website in your desktop or in your PCs. Okay, that's why we can easily get the contents if I am not internet connected to the internet. Okay, if you have no connection in the internet in your PCs, then you can easily get the content, the particular content easily, because this content is already saved into your computer system. Okay. Next thing is okay, saving pictures from a web page. Saving pictures from a website, web page. Okay. For example, this is a web page. This is a web page, some kind of web page. Say like, okay, this is a tutorial point websites. Okay, here there are some programming here. Okay. There is a picture is available, say like this is a C++ picture, this is a C++ image. Okay, now this C++ icon you want to download. You want to download. Because you like this logo of the C++. Okay, for a reason you have to saving the pictures from a particular website. This is a website, tutorial point value websites. From a tutorial point, you want to save this C++ icon. This is the image. Okay, you want to save the image into your desktop, into your PC. Okay, so you can see here, just there are three steps is given here. Right click the pictures and click the save pictures as options. In the save picture dialog box, browse to the folder where you want to save the file, and then after that click the save button. Okay. Just right click on the pictures, and after that select the save as options. Save as option. After that you just select the desired folder. For example, I am to select D drive, and there is an image folder, and in the image folder you just save the pictures. Okay, so in this way you can select the pictures first, right click on the picture and select the save as options. After that you just select the particular folder. Okay, now in this way we can easily select a picture, and after that we can save the pictures from a web page. Okay, I can see there is a table given here, save pictures without opening it. Okay, if you want to not increase the size of the web page, for example, so sometimes
okay.
Sometimes this is a Google website. Okay, this is a google.com. Okay, where you write, just write C++ icon. You write these options and after you just search the button. And after that, there are lot of images. There are lot of images opening. Lot of images. Thousands, lakhs of images opening. So see, everything is C++. Okay. Now, if you want to select a particular picture, if you want to select a particular picture, say like I want this particular picture or this particular image. Okay. So, for example, if you again click here, it will expand the picture. It will increase the pixels, the size of the pixels, everything, and it will also open that particular website. These pixels are actually stored some particular websites. When you click on the pixels, it will open this particular websites. Okay. For example, if you don't want to go to that particular websites where the C++ icons are saved, you just see the pixels in the google.com, and after that right click on the pixels and just directly click save options. At a time it was, you just save a web page, save pixels without opening it. You are not going to open the pixels directly, save from the image of from the Google websites. Okay. Now you see here, my method is given here. Right click on the items you want to save and then click the save target options. Means what? Right click on the target option. This is the target you want to save the website. Right click on target and directly save target as options. Next one is copy information from a web page into a document. For example, say like here some programming language, is a C++ programming language. Say like example here some example of the programming language. Say like is a C++ programming language. There is a program is given here. You just want to copy this text. There is a text basically. When you copy this text and after that you just paste and any other file. First of all, you just select the. First of all, you have to select the text and after that copy and after that paste. Paste means where? Say like Word file, text file, any other file. You just paste this. What? You just paste this text file. Okay. So here you can see here copy information from a web page into a document. Select the information you want to copy, right click on the selected copy options from the shortcut menu, then paste the information into the document you are working on, say Word 2010. Next one is create a desktop shortcut of the current page. Okay. For example, this is a web page tutorial point, is a web page. You want to create a shortcut of this web page. Create a shortcut. Just right click on this particular web page and after that select shortcut. That's a very easy process. Okay, that's a very easy process. And after that, you will create a shortcut in your desktop. When you click on this shortcut option on the desktop, you will directly go to the web page. Okay, it will open directly for a particular web page. Okay, next one is use your web page picture as the desktop background. Right click the image on the web page and then click the set as a background options. Okay, say like if you want to select this C++ icon or you like this picture, then you want to create this picture as a desktop background. Okay, this is your desktop. You want to create the background of this desktop. Okay, this C++ will be coming and inserting the desktop in your like the background. Okay, for the reason, you just click on this image and after that select save as a background. Next one is send a picture, show an email. Means you want to send a picture through an email. Right click the picture on the web page and select email picture options. Fill the email field and then send the message. Note that you must have an email account and email program set up on your computer to send the picture through email. For example, you want to send this C++ pictures through a particular person. So that's why you just first select this picture and after that right click on the pictures and select email picture options. There is the option is given here, email picture option. Just select this option and it will automatically redirect to your Gmail account or any other account. I have Gmail account, so directly it will open the Gmail account. Okay, my Gmail account will be open and after that give the particular web email ID where you want to send this information, to whom you want to send this information, and after that just click the send option. It will automatically send these pictures through an email. Okay, so this is very easy. You just see this information from the book. Okay, now next one is favorite option. Favorites. Okay, favorite means what? Favorite is nothing. It is just a link. It is a link that provides quick and easy access to a web page. It is just a link. It is just a what? Favorite is a link that provides quick and easy access to a web page. It is an easy way to access a web page. For example, I visit google.com, number 2, wikipedia.com, number 3, gmail.com, number 4, youtube.com. So I frequently visit these websites. So I frequently visit these websites, for example google.com, wikipedia.com, gmail.com or youtube.com. Okay, so for example I frequently visit Wikipedia and YouTube. Okay, so if I want to create a favorite, then we can easily access these websites. So just one click. Means what? For example, if you want to access YouTube, then you have to write www.youtube.com. Okay. After that, here go option. After that, you will get the YouTube option, YouTube websites. That's why. So if you want to visit a website, you have to type this URL and in the address bar. Okay. However, there might be some websites that you visit regularly. Some websites you have to visit regularly, say google.com, wikipedia.com, gmail, youtube.com. Okay. So every time you visit the website, you have to type this URL. Say example www.youtube.com, because I frequently visit YouTube account. Okay, I frequently visit YouTube websites. Okay, so in order to avoid typing the URL again, so if you want to avoid this URL typing again and again, then what you can do, add the required websites or the web page to the favorite list. Means what? If you want to avoid this typing this youtube.com again and again, So you can just copy this means URL and paste in the path the favorite options. You create a what? Just create a favorite list. Just create the favorite list of this web page or websites. So favorite is a what? It is a web page or it is a call. It is a link that provides quick and easy access to your web page. Favorite is a link which is used to easily and quickly access any web page which is frequently visited. For example, google.com, wiki.com and gmail.com or youtube.com. These are the four websites I frequently visit. So that's why I can create a favorite list, and in the list we just add these four websites so that we can get the websites easily. So that's why no need to write this URL again and again. Just go to the favorite options and after that click the desired websites. Okay. So now there is a steps are given here how to add the favorite into your favorite list, how to add any particular websites into your favorite list. The steps are given here. Just follow these steps. It's very useful. It's very important in your examination. It will become there. What is actually favorite and how to create a favorite list from your Internet Explorer. Today I think you understand today's topic. Okay, how to create favorites, how to save a web page, how to print a web page. Okay, what is the advantage of saving a web page? So all the things very important. Just you concentrate on your study. And if you have any problem after watching this video, just comment me or you can join our .fm sessions. Again, I every video I request everyone there, please join the doubt-free sessions. It is so important. Okay, so that's why I'm requesting everyone that please join our doubt-free sessions. It is so important for you. Okay, thank you everybody for watching this video. Hope everyone is well. Stay at home and be safe. Thank you everybody. Have a great day. Thank you.